Greetings everyone, today I am going to show you how to one-click install and run two ComfyUI workflows. The first one is generating a picture of a clothing, any clothing with a person so that you can generate random persons with the specific clothing. The second one is turning an image into a 3D figure. So these two workflows are from this repository, and making them one click to install and run was really hard. I have worked whole day to prepare for you so that it will be very easy for you to just install and run, and hopefully today I am going to show you how to run these two workflows with such easiness. First of all, you need to install ComfyUI. If you already have installed it, just download our zip file. The link will be in the description of the video. Move the zip file into your ComfyUI installation folder, or just watch this tutorial and install it and learn it. After you move it, right click and extract all into same folder. Actually, it extracted into another folder, so the best way is WinRAR extract here, so it will overwrite and update everything. Then Windows update ComfyUI.bat file, more info run anyway. This will update your ComfyUI to the latest version. If you make a fresh installation, it will be already update. Then you will see this workflows folder, enter inside it and enter inside transfer cloth and turn into 3D. Then double click install clothing and 3D.bat file, more info run anyway. This will install necessary nodes and the requirements. Yes, we seen a red here. This is not important. It will work. Just wait for installation to be completed, and it is done and ready. This installed all the custom nodes and the requirements. Then we need to download the necessary models. To download them, I will use our SwarmUI auto installer and the ultimate model downloader. You see there is version 32 right now. Always use the latest version. Then you can either install it as seen in this video, or just move back into your previous installation and then right click WinRAR extract here and overwrite all the files. So this will update your application to the latest version. Then double click Windows start download modules app.bat file, more info run anyway. It will update the requirements if there is any update, and it is started. So you see currently this is version 32. When you are watching this video, it can be even better. So how we are going to download the modules? I have added new modules here. We can see that there is image generation modules, Flux modules, and for this tutorial I will download Flux dev 1.0 GGUF Q8. You can also use the regular model, both of them works. Actually, I will also show that. So where we will download this? We need to download them inside ComfyUI, inside models folder. So copy your path of ComfyUI, paste it here. By default, this is made for SwarmUI, but this works fully with ComfyUI as well. And also check this checkbox for ComfyUI. Then we can begin downloading. So first click this Flux Dev version 1 GGUF Q8. If you have a lower VRAM GPU, like 12 GB or even lower, you can also download lower models. So it is up to you, like Q4 or Q5. The Q8 version is almost same quality as FP16, and this shows the quality comparison of the GGUF. This applies to all models, whether it is Flux or other video models. So Q8 is better than Q6, better than Q5, better than Q4, and also if there are letters, KM is better than KS, better than K, better than 1 and 0. Okay, let's click this one. It will be added to the queue and it will be automatically downloaded. Since I already have it, is skip. Then at the very bottom you will see there is ComfyUI workflows bundles. The first bundle is clothing migration workflow bundle. This will download all of the necessary modules for these two workflows that I am going to show. So it will start downloading and we can see that everything is already downloaded. Let's verify. Yes, so the queue is zero and everything is downloaded because I had downloaded them previously. Now I am ready to start using these workflows. So let's just start our ComfyUI with Windows run gpu.bat file, more info run anyway. By the way, you can open this bat file with any text editor and remove this use sage attention. This is not mandatory, but this is speeding up with a little bit trade-off quality decrease. So it is up to you. You can also add other parameters to here. This is how the ComfyUI is getting their parameters. So our ComfyUI is starting. Just wait for the start. Okay, the interface has started. So the workflows are inside workflows folder and we have the workflows here. So let's begin with the loading workflow. You can either drag and drop this or the image itself, and this is the workflow. So first of all, you need to pick your clothing image. So I have these clothings, for example. Let's pick this one. Then what parameters you need to change? The most important parameter that you need to change is prompt. According to your generation, this will generate a new person by using the Flux dev model. So we are not providing a person here. Then the other parameters that you can change is adding some text here, or here you can add the text too is coming from there, and there is also automatically captioning. We will see the final text. You see there is also some extra prompts here, and this part is very important. This changes according to your GPU. Currently I am using Flux Dev GGUF Q8, but you can use other Flux Dev models as well. So if you are using a lower different GGUF, you need to select it from here. Moreover, we have even a block swapping feature for even more lower VRAM. You see, we select our Flux Dev model. This is FP16 model, and you can set the block swapping, and this will use way lower VRAM. So all you need to do is just drag and drop this here. Let me show you. Okay, I don't understand why this is like this. Maybe you can tell me later, but let's make it like yes. So now it will use this for generating the output. This will be slower, but this will use way lower VRAM than the other version. And this will be also maximum quality because we are loading the model as an FP16 weight. You can also load as an FP8 for speed up and also lower VRAM consumption. But if you want the maximum quality, then you need to use this default or use GGUF Q8. I am explaining these in details because this doesn't change with other models. This is the logic of loading models. Then everything else has been automatically downloaded into our accurate folder. What other parameters that you can play is the CFG guider. This is impacting the output. I find that 1.5 is good. 3.5 were generating blurry images for me, so I made it 1.5. There is also generation resolution. So the width and height of the image changes according to the input clothing image. Yes, here you see there is scale image to total pixels. So you set the final output resolution from here. By default it is 1 megapixel, so that is the best resolution for the Flux. And we are ready. We just run and let's see how it is running. I will open my nvitop as usual. So nvitop, and we can monitor what is happening here. So first of all, it is going to load the metal llama. By the way, I made it by default an F4, so it is 4-bit quantization. It uses a little bit amount of VRAM. You can also change this to BF16 if you have a high VRAM GPU, like 24 gigabytes of GPU, to get a better, you know, automatic captioning. We will see the final user text here. So this will give you a lot of ideas of how it works. Photograph cloud on. This is specific to this model. You can read more information here about this model. It is combination of several sub models and other stuff. And we will see the final text here. As I said, the photograph cloud on, the image pair highlights a transformation from a clothing sample. Just pause the video and read it. So this will be the final prompt. I am using T5XXL FP16. This can be also changed with GGUF, but you can also make this a CPU because this is only used for encoding. Then it is unloaded, so it is not kept in your VRAM. Therefore, it is not very important. We are using some specific models, but these are all downloaded with our automatic downloader, so you don't spend time with them. You see there is migration Lora, there is Flux Inpainting, a specific Inpainting from Llama. So yes, this is a very, very advanced workflow, and making this much easier to install and use was a huge task, believe me. And we are going to see the image in a moment here. Currently it is using a lot of VRAM because I am using Q8 GGUF. But as I said, if you use this, it is as low as like 8 or 10 gigabytes of VRAM, not much. So you can use this, you can make this as 1, so it will use minimum amount of VRAM if you don't have a powerful GPU. And we got the image. This is a really decent image. I mean, look at this. This is the clothing that we used, and this is on a person. You can also inpaint the face and improve it, but this is a really good by default already. So the second workflow is turning persons into a 3D figure. So let's drag and drop it here, and it is set automatically. So what you can set here is, again, you can set the Llama. You can set a prompt in here. It is not mandatory, but you can set them, you can play with them. You can again change the model loader from GGUF to Flux UNET loader with CPU dynamic offload, which is block swapping, which the Cohia is also using for training with very low amount of VRAM. Like, we can train the Flux with as low as 6 gigabytes of VRAM. And that's it. It will also show the final prompt here. So let's just run it. By the way, don't forget to upload the person that you want to generate, like a 3D toy, we can say. And let's just wait the output here. The rest is just regular ComfyUI usage. So let's just wait. Again, on our channel, this video is showing you how to install ComfyUI and how to install SwarmUI downloader, also SwarmUI itself. I really prefer SwarmUI, but I will be doing some more ComfyUI workflows hopefully as well. Our ComfyUI installer is extremely advanced. It automatically installs all the best attentions and other stuff for you. Let me show you. So we can see that it is already supporting NVIDIA 5090. It supports also older GPUs like 4090 or 4060, 3060, 2000, it doesn't matter. It supports all the GPUs, including 5000 series. Also, we can see that it has Saga attention by default. It also has flash attention and X-formers too. So don't worry about that. So our ComfyUI installation is just perfect. Also, it is installed into a virtual environment so that you can have multiple ComfyUI installations, or you can just delete your virtual environment and remake it. So there is no issues, there is no problems with that. If your ComfyUI gets broken, just delete the virtual environment and remake it. So this is extremely accurate and most performant way of installing ComfyUI without breaking any other of your ComfyUI installations, or without breaking your computer, without breaking any other of your applications. And yes, we got our image. This is not exactly face matching, but it is kind of matching. You can see the final prompt here, and you can modify it according to your needs, change it, play just with it a little bit, and whatever you like, you will get. So this is how I am going to make my hopefully future ComfyUI. They will be just one click to install, one click to use with optimizations. So thank you so much for watching. Subscribe and wait for more tutorials, because they are hopefully coming very soon.